Hello students, today we are going to start our next chapter, congruence of triangles. Basically, this is the first part of congruence of triangles, in which we will study about what are the congruent figures and some type of congruent figures. After that, we will solve exercise 7.1. So first, let us understand what are the congruent figures. If two figures have exactly the same shape and size, then they are said to be congruent figures. Now let us understand it with the help of some points. So here you can see that we have two rupees coin and 1 5 rupee coin. Okay, let us place them. Now if we talk about the shape of these coins, then you can see that all these three coins have the same shape, that is circular shape. The shape is circular. Okay, the shape of this 5 rupee coin is also circular. But what about the size? If we ask you about the size of these 2 rupees coin, then you can see that these 2 rupees coin have the same size. Why? Because when you place this coin over this 2 rupee coin, then you can see these 2 rupees coin cover each other exactly. Hence, you can see that these two coins of 2 rupees have the same size. So, the shape is circular and also they have same size. Hence, we can say these two rupees coin are congruent. The sign of the congruency is this. So, we can represent these two rupees coin by this sign, because these are congruent to each other. Now, if we talk about 1 2 rupee coin and 1 5 rupee coin, then you can see that these two coins have the same shape, that is circular shape, but their size are not same. Hence, we can say these two coins have different size. Okay. So we cannot say the 2 rupee coin is congruent to 5 rupee coin, because when we place this 5 rupee coin over the 2 rupee coin, then you can see that these two coins cannot cover each other exactly. Hence, these two coins are not congruent. So I hope, students, it is clear that two figures are said to be congruent if they have exactly the same shape and same size. Now we will study about some types of congruent figures. So first, when we will say two line segments are congruent. So two line segments are congruent if they have the same length. Let us see here, there are two line segments AB and CD. If we measure the length of these two line segments, then you can see that AB measures 5 cm and CD measures also 5 cm. As these two line segments AB and CD have the same length, AB equals to CD. Hence, we can say AB is congruent to CD. Now let us see, these two lines EF and LM are congruent or not. So if you measure the length of the EF, then you can see it measures 7.5, that is, it is 7.5 cm. But the line segment LM measures only 6 cm. Hence, you can see that the measure of the line segment EF and LM are not equal. Hence, we can say these two line segments are not congruent. So, two line segments are said to be congruent only if they have the same length. Now, let us see the condition for congruence of two angles. Two angles are congruent if they have same measure. So here you can see that angle AOB measures 50 degree and angle COD also measure 50 degree. So we can write as measure of angle AOB is equals to measure of angle CDE, measure of angle CDE equals to 50 degree. Hence we can say these two angles are congruent. These two angles are congruent. So two angles are congruent if they have the same measure. Similarly, two squares are congruent if they have the same side length. Here we have two squares PQRS and EFGH. Let us see these two squares are congruent or not. So first we will measure the side length of these squares. So here you can see that the measure of the line segment PQ, that is the side of this square PQRS, measures 4 cm. This is also 4 cm. All the side measures 4 cm. In the same way, when we measure the length of the side of the square EFGH, then you can see each side measure 4 cm also here. So this is also 4 cm. Now we can see that these two squares PQRS and EFGH have the same side length, that is 4 cm. So we can say as the side length, that is PQ is equals to EF. Hence we can say these two squares are congruent to each other. So two squares are said to be congruent if they have the same side length. Now let us see the condition for congruency of two rectangles. So two rectangles are congruent if they have the same length and same breadth. So here we have two rectangles ABCD and DEFG. Now let us measure the length and breadth of these two rectangles. So here you can see that the length of the rectangle ABCD measures 6 cm. And the breadth of the rectangle measures 3.5 cm. In the same way, the length of the rectangle DEFG measures also 6 cm. And the breadth measures 3.5 cm. So you can see that these two rectangles have the same length and same breadth. So we can say these two rectangles are congruent. In the same way, we can define the congruency of two circles. So two circles are congruent if they have the same radius. So here you can see that there are two circles C1 and C2. And both these circles C1 and C2 have the same radius of length 2.2 cm. Hence we can say as radius of both circles C1 and C2 measures 2.2 cm, that is the same length. Hence we can say these two circles C1 and C2 are congruent to each other. Okay, so two circles are congruent if they have the same radius. Now we will see congruence of triangles. Two triangles are congruent if pairs of corresponding sides and corresponding angles are equal. So here we have considered two triangles ABC and DEF. So these two triangles are congruent if That is, we can write triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF if the side AB is equals to DE, AB is equals to DE, BC is equals to EF, and AC is equals to DF. That is, the corresponding sides are equal. Also, angle A is equals to angle D. Angle A is equals to angle D. Angle B is equals to angle E. Angle B is equals to angle E. And angle C is equals to angle F. Then triangle ABC is said to be congruent to each other. Okay. It also means that if we place this triangle DEF over the triangle ABC such that the side DE falls on the side AB, the side EF falls on the side BC, and the side DF falls on the side AC. Also, the vertices D match with A, E match with B, and F match with C. Then these two triangles covers each other exactly. Okay, so this is the meaning of congruency of two triangles. Now students, how we will identify the pairs of corresponding angles, pairs of corresponding vertices, and pairs of corresponding sides if we have given two congruent triangles? So first let us suppose that we have given that triangle PQR is congruent to triangle LMN. So first we will see corresponding vertices. Corresponding vertices. Now students, here in this triangle PQR, you can see that the first letter is P, and in triangle LMN, the first letter is L. So we can say the first pair of corresponding vertices is P and L. P and L. Again, in this triangle PQR, the second letter is Q, and in this triangle LMN, the second letter is M. Hence, the second pair of corresponding vertices is Q and M. And the third pair is R and M. That is last letter of these two triangles. Now let us see the pair of corresponding sides. Corresponding sides. Okay. So here you can see that if we take the first two letters, that is PQ of the triangle PQR, then the first two letters of the triangle LMN is LM. Hence we can say side PQ correspond to side LM. PQ and LM is one pair of corresponding side. In the same way, the last two letters, that is QR, corresponds to last two letter in this triangle LMN, that is MN. Hence we have the next pair QR and MN. Again, the third pair is if we take the first and third letter of this triangle PQR, that is PR, then it corresponds to first and third letter of the triangle LMN, that is LN. Hence, we can say the third pair of corresponding side is PR and LN. Now here, in these triangles PQR and LMN, you can see the first letter is P and here the first letter is L. So we can say the corresponding pair of angle is P and L. Angle P and angle L. The next pair is angle Q, that is second letter, and here the second letter angle M. So angle Q and angle M. And the third pair is angle R correspond to angle M, that is last letter of both these triangles, angle R and angle M. So I hope it is clear that how to identify the pairs of corresponding vertices, sides and angles if we have given two congruent triangles. Now let us move to exercise 7.1, and here the first question is given that complete the following statements. First, two line segments are congruent if. So you know the condition for congruency of two line segment is that they must have the same length. Hence we can say two line segments are congruent if they have the same length. Now the next one is, among two congruent angles, one has the measure of 70 degree, the measure of other angle is. So it is given in question that the two angles are congruent, and you know the condition for congruency of two angles is that these two angles must have the same measure. So if one has a measure of 70 degree, then the measure of other angle must be 70 degree. Okay. Now the third one is, when we write angle A equals to angle B, then we actually mean, then this means that measure of the angle A is equals to measure of angle B. Hence we can write here, measure of angle A equals to measure of angle B. The next question we have, if triangle DEF is congruent to triangle BCA, write the parts of triangle BCA that correspond to angle E, line segment DF, angle F and the line segment DF. Now students, I have already told you, if two triangles are given which are congruent, then how to identify the corresponding pairs of vertices, angles and sides. So here it is given that there are two triangles D, E, F, which is congruent to the triangle BCA. So we have to identify the corresponding part to the angle E, EF, angle F and DF. So first let us see angle E. So when you see this triangle DEF, then you can see that E comes in the middle. So we have to find the middle term in the triangle BCA. Now in this triangle BCA, you can see that the middle term is C. Hence we can say the corresponding angle to angle E is the angle C. So our answer is angle C. Now let us see the next line segment EF. So here you can see in the triangle DEF, the line segment EF is the last two letters of this triangle. So let us see the last two letters of the triangle BCA. So the last two letters of the triangle BCA is the CA. Hence we can say the line segment EF corresponds to the line segment CA. Hence our answer is CA. In the same way, let us find the corresponding pair of angle F. So angle F in the triangle DEF comes in last. And here in the triangle BCA, you can see the last term is angle A. Hence, we can say angle F corresponds to angle A. Hence, our answer is angle A. The next is line segment DF. So here in this triangle DEF, you can see the position of D and F is first and third. Similarly, first and third position in the triangle BCA is B and A. Hence, we can say the line segment DF corresponds to the line segment BA. Hence, our answer is BA. Okay, students? Now, rest of the questions you have to solve by yourself. Thank you.